It's been 20 years since Lou Nanni came back to work at his alma mater, but who's counting, right? He is the vice president for university relations and, as such, oversees development operations and the greatest alumni association in the world. Lou, thank you so much.
Thank you, Dane Murray, and thank you for being. I know this is your first Notre Dame Day experience. We feel really blessed to have you in the partnership with WSBT. We're really, really grateful for.
I'm so glad to be a part of this.
Great.
So much fun, so much fun. So, really historic day.
It really is.
We just broke
the record.
Tell us about
for
that.
For the number of gifts, we have topped over 30,000 distinct Notre Dame donors. I have to thank, we have the most fabulous team, development team here at Notre Dame. We have absolutely incredible partners like you, so many others that have been working for the last 30 plus hours behind the scenes.
Yeah.
And then we have the best Notre Dame family that anybody could ever hope for in the world. The alumni, parents, and friends that have rallied together to support this place, we feel inordinately blessed.
Absolutely. What about the votes? What can you tell us about the votes?
So the votes, the tallies are very high.
Mm-hmm.
We still are breaking them down, but, you know, this is all about trying to tell Notre Dame's story in its many and varied dimensions. And then beyond that, to drive engagement, participation. It's more about the number of donors than it is about the size of the gifts. And that participation is something that buoys everybody's spirit around here. And again, we feel abundantly blessed by the turnout and the support through the 6th annual Notre Dame Day.
Yeah, and financial aid always gets a lot of votes. Tell us about the push for that.
It is. It's huge. And, you know, sometimes people think that, you know, a smaller gift isn't going to mean anything at Notre Dame.
Right.
Well, last year, in gifts of $200 or less, those gifts alone provided full rides for 37 Notre Dame students.
That's incredible.
Gifts of $200 or less. So if you think that a gift of that magnitude doesn't make a difference, I'm sorry, but you are blatantly wrong. It makes a huge difference. 37 kids are here this year because of gifts of that magnitude last year.
Such a great way to put it into perspective for people. Now, it's been a long 29 hours for many people, including yourself. What's been your favorite part of this?
You know, I would probably have to say that the stories each time kind of blow you away. And we have 5 children, and our youngest is a third grader. And she was here last night, and she stood right over here as we sat and watched this this woman from Uganda who was interviewed, who had been held captive for 8 years, kidnapped, and
incredible.
And 2 children were born in captivity and escaped, fortunately, but after 8 grueling years, and then found her way to a full scholarship in the Keough School for Global Affairs Master's Program. And just listening to her story and seeing my 9-year-old here with me, and then afterwards having Sophia, my daughter, ask if she could take her picture with her. And then asking her if maybe she could come and speak to her school.
Oh.
Stories of resilience and hope,
she's
overcoming tremendous
daughter.
Adversity. What an impact that has on not only people like you and me, but on kids like Sophia. And I'm just filled with hope. And no matter how difficult things can get, given the human condition, people like that show us Victoria. Shows us that you can be resilient, that you can overcome, that what we can do with faith and what we can do with family is absolutely amazing.
That is so true. Now, you've been doing Notre Dame Day for 6 years. How has it changed over the years?
You know, it's just grown and it's garnered more and more momentum. Probably what's most exciting about it is our students are taking more and more possession of Notre Dame Day. And that's really exciting. You know that we have over 400 Notre Dame student clubs and organizations. Over half the money that they get for the work that they do comes through Notre Dame Day.
Really?
And this is amazing. Talking to student groups last year, one group came to us and said it was through Notre Dame Day that we were able to dig 7 additional wells in Africa. Another group said we were able to build 2 more footbridges in Central America to connect rural, poor communities. Another group said that we were able to buy additional kind of exercise equipment for our dorm. All across the board, the stories are really meaningful and impactful to our students, and they're the ones that are going out and soliciting folks to step up and give back to Notre Dame Day.
Right, and I think a lot of people think that they're giving money to the university, but that money goes to so many different countries and just everywhere to help so many people, right?
Exactly. So we've had over 100 countries, viewers from over 100 countries tune in to Notre Dame Day
this year.
And that's exactly right. Notre Dame is more of a conduit through which we can impact real world problems.
Sure.
And so we look at that. Notre Dame Father Soren, when he founded the university, he didn't found it just to be one of the greatest universities in the land, but more importantly, one of the greatest forces for good in all of society. 1% of the world's population has a college degree. If we're not asking ourselves every day at the University of Notre Dame, how are we making ourselves relevant to the other 99%, mm-hmm. then we've missed the boat. And so that's what this Notre Dame Day is about. It's about trying to be leaven for a world that is deeply, deeply in need.
You totally wrapped it up for us right there. Lou, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Dana Marie.
Absolutely.
And we hope you'll be back next year.
Without a doubt.
Okay.
Definitely will be.